Can I do something for you, Mr. Bond?
Just a drink. A martini, shaken, not stirred.
Well, la-dee frickin' da! We got ourselves a writer here! Hey, Dad, I can't see real good. Is that Bill Shakespeare over there?
Better Each Day podcast radio show with Bruce Hilliard. Today and every day, reaching out for innovative ideas in every way. Yeah, today's show is brought to you by your future. It comes with a lifetime guarantee.
Ooh, make it better stay now, baby.
Well, we lost the original James Bond. Sir Sean Connery has passed. It's Halloween 2020, a year to remember indeed. Welcome to the Better Each Day podcast, Trick or Treat, from 6 feet, throw the candy to the street. I'm Bruce Hilliard, and I approve this message. Set your clocks back, wear your mask, drink your Ovaltine, and wash your junk. This year is fraught with fright. Los Angeles won both the NBA championship and the World Series, but the LA fans weren't allowed to attend the games. Only cutouts and a select few.
I was working in the lab late one night when my eyes beheld an eerie sight. For my monster from his slab began to rise, and suddenly, to my surprise, He did the monster mash.
Dressing up in costumes for Halloween. Where the hell did that come from? Well, the Brewster looked it up on the internet, and here it is. Dressing up in costumes was once a way to hide from ghosts. The tradition originated as a way for the Celtic and other European people to hide from the spirits who returned at this time of the year. People wore masks when they left their homes after dark so the ghosts would think they were fellow spirits. This year, there's a world of masked people everywhere, and the ghosts are thinking they're at Comic-Con. Halloween falls on a blue moon. Okay, a blue moon in the Northern Hemisphere, but that's okay for the sake of my point, since Halloween is celebrated only in the Northern Hemisphere anyway. The first full moon of this month fell on October 1st. It was the Northern Hemisphere's harvest moon, or a full moon nearest the September equinox. This month we'll have a second full moon, which by popular decree shall be called a blue moon. It will come on October 31st, which is today, the night of Halloween. There won't be another blue moon on Halloween for another 19 years. The next time we'll do the math here, there will be a blue moon on Halloween, will be the year 2039. Even scarier is the presidential election. In a few days, there will be votes followed by accusations of fraud and blame. Blame never results in progress, but that seems to be what fuels our candidates' narratives. Hey, and in the three-year tradition of Better Each Day Halloweens, here's former guest Sanar about talking with the dead. It's always a Halloween treat to have you, Sanar. Please continue with your story.
And he was just very emphatic that I needed to return immediately and talk with his mother, that the younger brother was in trouble. And I said, well, let me just walk for a little bit and I'll go back. And it was like he showed me a picture, a visual of what was happening in the room of the younger brother. And it was, to be perfectly honest, one of the scariest things I've ever seen. And I've seen a lot of stuff.
Welcome to the Better Each Day podcast radio show with Bruce Hilliard. Today and every day, reaching out for innovative ideas in every way. Today's show is brought to you by your future. It comes with a lifetime guarantee.
All right, he's done. Please continue.
There are a lot of things that can happen. It's not like math, you know, where things add up or don't. You know, it's really, you don't know what doors you're opening when you're opening doors, and you don't know who you're bringing in when you're calling stuff, and you don't know, you know, who you're confronting if you're going into a haunted prison or something like that. Like, yeah, it's really cute to experience someone who's been imprisoned and hanged, and you can still feel them. It's like, I personally don't find that engaging. I'd rather let them go, but that's probably a cooperative experience for, you know, imagine the guy's probably just an actor, the spirit going, hey, time to hang, okay.
And now here's the story about me that you'll all enjoy. One Halloween in about 1959, when I was about 4, my mom took an old sheet and cut out some eye holes and dressed me up as a ghost. She dropped me off with some strangers in the basement of our church and left me with 1,000 other kids dressed as hobos and witches and various other crap. We played a game that involved closing our eyes and being spun around by one of the grown-up 13-year-old girls. When I opened my eyes, I couldn't see anything but white sheet. I started to wander. I found a wall to use as a guide, and after a minute or two of feeling my way around, I heard a door close, and there I was in darkness. The next day, they found me in the coat closet.
The captain's conferring with someone. Can't quite see who. Oh, yes, I believe it's Professor Pearson. Yes, it is. Now they've parted, and the professor moves around one side, studying the object while the captain and two policemen advance with something in their hands. I can see it now. It's a white handkerchief tied to a pole. Flag of truce. If those creatures know what that means, what anything means. Wait a minute, something's happening. A humped shape is rising out of the pit. I can make out a small beam of light against a mirror. What's that? There's a jet of flame springing from the mirror, and it leaps right at the advancing men. It strikes them head on. Lord, they're turning into flames. Ah! The whole field's caught up by the woods, the barns. They're gas heading everywhere. Coming this way now, about 20 yards.
That's right. So cool. That was an excerpt from Orson Welles' War of the Worlds from an October 30th, 1938 radio show, The Original Fake News. It caused mass hysteria and inspired journalists to this very day. And by request, a song I recently wrote about Saturday nights. A girl wants to go where the other kids are going, the local Saturday night shootout. She puts on her best jeans, checks herself out in the mirror. All systems go, except your mama won't let you go.
Let you go.
Here's a sneak preview of a song I'm working on called Gypsy Woman.
Got a call, didn't want to hear. Said a brother disappeared. Silence echoed in my ears. We hadn't talked in many years. Somehow it
trick-or-treaters are knocking at the door. I'm going to the door to look at their innocent little faces, remind them to remain 6 feet away from everything, wash their hands, wear a seatbelt, eat your broccoli, don't run with scissors, take your Flintstone vitamins, look both ways before crossing the street, and if a freak in the street grabs you, scream like hell, don't bet on slow horses, and above all, have a happy Halloween 2020. They only come once in a blue moon.
I sit alone and wonder why. Gypsy woman, make a better stay in our baby. Oh, better in every way.
You've been listening to the Better Each Day podcast radio show with Bruce Hilliard. We'll be back with a new horizon, but until then, honor the future. It comes with a lifetime guarantee.
And we're all just trying to make the next day a bit better.